In the past 3 years, I have made it my goal to try and eat every single chili dog in the greater Boston area. And in that time, I managed to eat 58 chili dogs. I encourage you to watch part 1 and 2 if you haven't already, in which I give some context behind this quest, review some of the worst chili dogs, discuss what I think makes an excellent chili dog, and review some of the most surprising chili dogs. Now, before getting to my favorite chili dogs, here are 8 chili dogs that deserve a shout out. Spike's Junkyard. One of the most famous hot dog places in Boston. It also was the first chili dog that I had on this quest, July of 2017. I also returned several months later after I got a more refined taste in chili dogs. I'm sorry to disappoint that their chili dog did not stand out. I prefer no beans and cheese, which they had an abundance of. That being said, they have a wide assortment of way more delicious hot dog offerings, so definitely check them out. Janet's Chili Dogs. This truck is special because it seems to be the only place in the state that is a dedicated chili dog place. Janet sold it off a few years ago, and the workers there had no idea why Janet started this chili dog, so the mystery remains. So if you know the answer, please comment below. Overall, the chili was fairly decent, though I wasn't a fan of the soft buns and the steamed dogs. Coney Island. This was a very famous place in Worcester. It was quick, small, and cheap. A very standard dog, and honestly nothing very special about it, sorry. But definitely a historic place to check out. Sauce. For those vegetarians and vegans out there, you can get a chili dog at Sauce. It gets points for that and not much else. The dog was made of impossible meat, but honestly nothing can beat the taste and texture of real meat. And the chili dog was kind of bland. But a good alternative. All-Star Sandwich and Bar. Very excellent chili dog. It was probably the spiciest dog I've had. That being said, it wasn't spicy at all, and arguably it had a perfect balance. The chili consisted of a pulled pork with no beans, topped with some red onions and cilantro. The jack cheese under the chili really added a lot too. It would get more points if it were cleaner to eat. Though I got this during COVID time, so I had to get it to go, which is hard to do with a chili dog. But it was a very wet meal. Mostly from the slice of pickle that was on the side, but also the chili was juicy, but not wet, which is a very important distinction. Muya. Muya wins the award for best buns. They were soft, fresh, and buttery. The rest of the chili dog was merely mediocre. This also doesn't really count because this is a nationwide chain. Additionally, going to their website, I can't seem to find chili dogs anywhere. Maybe they removed it recently? Anybody know? Comment below. The Dog Father. Standard dog and standard bun, but they are famous for their award-winning chili. Indeed, it was definitely one of the best chilies I had. There was a hint of cinnamon that you can easily smell and taste, which adds a whole nother layer to their already tender and savory chili. My middle school cafeteria. By the way, besides my appearance, I am a teacher and not a student at that middle school. Also, this doesn't really count because this is a one-time lunch offering that they haven't served since, and it's usually frowned upon if the general public tried to go in and tried to buy a hot dog, a chili dog from them. But for school, chili dog was one of the better lunches that I've had at that school. Now for my favorite chili dog in the greater Boston area. The Art Bradish Snack Bar. Out of all the 58 chili dogs I've had, this is the best chili dog I've had. This family-run stand in Grafton since 1937 is famous for their hot dogs, their fried oysters, and their onion rings. But their chili dogs, though. What makes it so good? Their New England-style bun is generously buttered and then toasted on the grill. The narrow dog is grilled evenly, so when you take a bite into it, the casing gives a perfect amount of resistance and texture. The chili was savory, a little sweet, and had everything you wanted in there. The beauty of it is that it was simple, easy to eat, and manages to pack a lot of punch for its size. And by the way, in order to confirm that this was the best chili dog, I went back exactly 1 year later for another chili dog, and then I went back another time 1 year later for another chili dog. All of those experiences confirmed that this was the best chili dog. I also do realize that Grafton is arguably not Greater Boston, so here are some runner-ups for best chili dogs that are actually in or closer to Boston. Patios. My good friend Evan came along with me on many of my chili dog runs. He probably had at least 20 of these chili dogs, and this was his favorite. I liked it too. The bun was toasted. I thought it was toasted for a little too long and was too crunchy, but Evan really liked that. The dog was well grilled too. and on top it was loaded with chili and cheese. The savory chili was supplemented with bacon and onions. Zaftigs. The dog and bun were good and standard, but the chili was fantastic. The meat in it was this beef brisket that was extremely tender, just dissolved in your mouth. It was as if the chili had been slow cooking for days. I had mine at Coolidge Corner, but there's also a location in Natick. City Slicker. This was incidentally the last dog I had on my quest, and definitely surprising as well. It was a standard dog and bun, so the dog was thicker than average. The chili was also good but didn't stand out. But what made it great was 1. The simple addition of a strip of crispy bacon on the bottom. It helped soak up the juices, and of course bacon is delicious. But most importantly, it gave the chili dog a contrasting crunchy texture. The second thing that made this chili dog really special was the simple addition of coleslaw laid on the top of the whole thing, which gave it a surprising zesty delicious taste. Coleslaw in general is a hit or miss for me. It really depends on how much mayo and vinegar is used. I don't like my coleslaw too strong, and this definitely wasn't too strong. And it supplemented the rest of the chili dog very well. Most importantly, the chili dog gave me more of an illusion that it was a slightly healthier meal. Once again, these are all merely opinions. After 3 years and 58 chili dogs in the greater Boston area, these are my 4 favorite chili dogs. As I said, I never really intended to share this chili dog experience, but as my time in Boston has come to a close, and I'm literally 3 days away from moving across country, this seems like a good closing to my time here. Thank you, chili dogs. Thank you, you, and thank you, Boston.